2014 is here with 2 months in coming into our third month, and we still don't know officially of when Thousand Year Blood War Core 3 is going to be happening, but we may have some answers towards the end of this video. So in this video, come with me as we talk about some Bleach news and also some Core 3 potential news going on, and then I'll just leave it to your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. So let's get into it, shall we? Of course, if you like these type of videos and these updates, hit that like, subscribe, and of course, enjoy the video. So yeah, let's go. So first and foremost, if you haven't seen my tweet recently about Bleach Core 3, I made a tweet talking about summer for Bleach, and I'll talk a little bit more about that, but I kind of want to build up this little story about how we kind of got to this position in general and why this, you know, and again, I'm not really a leaker. I don't really do that thing anymore, but I still do hear things here and there. So hopefully it will give you a little bit more context in regards to that. So half of it is a bit of a 50-50 leak, and the other part of it is kind of business side of things. So hopefully we can come to a conclusion together, shall we? Let's go. So as I said, it's 2014. It's been about give or take 5 months since Core 2 actually happened with the ending of Senjimaru's Bankai. A lot of original content has happened. So we're going to be coming into the Core 3 with more original content going into Senjimaru's Bankai, and then whatever really kind of happens after that. As far as we know with the Bleach anime as a whole, of things that I want to talk about is that, yes, we're going to have a bit of a different-ish staff, so to say, and I don't want people to misinterpret what I'm meaning by this, is that you have people like, let's say, Hashimoto, who I believe has retired this year, maybe because he's too old, or maybe because he has some health conditions. I do believe, off the top of my head, I saw something in relation to cancer. But again, I don't really want to kind of talk about that just in case I do get it somewhat slightly wrong. But as far as we know, Hashimoto isn't going to be within the core staff of Bleach, as I do believe he's retired. And there's some, you know, people here and there as well. With Core 2, there was a bit of difficulties. I think Sakai had actually injured himself, and Hashimoto, of course, was having some medical issues. So, you know, I wouldn't say Core 2 was kind of involved with them per se. So I do believe there's probably some difficulties in production in regards to that. But nevertheless, we're going to have to see with Core 3 about the staff. We don't know much about the staff because there seems to be a restructuring of staff. Some people were let go. Some people are probably come into the studio. I've heard some good things, and I've heard also nothing at the same time. So however you want to perceive that is, again, up to you about who you want. Regardless of if you like Morita or not, I don't know. But regardless of what, in regards to Core 3, I think there's some big changes, and I'm really kind of interested and excited to see what the official releases are going to be saying and have a look at some of the new potentially core staff, because if Hashimoto's gone, there's going to be some new staff. Kudo, when are you actually going to animate something? Come on. You know, it's time. It's time. So I kind of do have a little bit of sympathy for the Bleach team. Now, let's talk about the Blu-ray. The Blu-ray, of course, is something that we would have already have talked about by now in terms of comparisons to the Blu-ray to the TV versions. We haven't had that because the Blu-ray for Bleach has been postponed. This is because of production issues. This doesn't inherently mean in terms of animation. It could be in terms of like manufacturing, actually producing the discs, producing whatever booklets, or producing, you know, little extras, stuff like that. So, you know, there was a bit of an issue in regards to manufacturing or production, so that Blu-ray release has been delayed, so there's no comparison as of yet because we don't really know when it's going to be released. So, you know, hopefully we get to do a video about that and that comes soon. So there's a bit of a drought when it comes to Bleach news as comparison from going from Core 1 into Core 2. I do think Core 2 did speed up a little bit of things, or it was a bit quicker than, you know, obviously for Core 1. But I think if they do it correctly this time going into Core 3, we're going to see some good promotion and a lot of things to talk about as a whole. So in regards to the Blu-ray, that was kind of our next thing to talk about, but because it's been postponed, there's a bit of a gap or a bit of limbo in regards to like things to talk about with Bleach. Now, of course, Studio Pierrot, if you're more so on the business side of things, they have had an interview recently, and there's been a lot of talks in regards to Pierrot, especially with the recent McDonald's thing that they recently done. Bit wild, you know, that they're struggling with Naruto's 4 episodes, but they go and do a McDonald's anime. But then again, if money talks, money talks, and money going into Pierrot, depending if there is a split or if there is a, you know, a share, you know, that Pierrot gets from like any profits, it could be good for Bleach. It could be good for Pierrot to get themselves back on the map and whatnot and get some more financial backing. But as far as we know from these interviews, McDonald's aside, we had one of the head licensors. Again, I'm going off the dome here. I'm not going off research. You'll see it on screen anyway. You have one of the licensors talk about how successful, and Naruto and Boruto wasn't mentioned, and the only reason why I'm bringing that up is because there is a strong emphasis on Bleach in regards to this, because there is obviously a lot of questions in regards to, is Bleach the Thousand Year Blood War arc being deemed as popular? And as much as the West like to use Crunchyroll numbers or Netflix numbers or whatever numbers they want to pull out their ass, or manga volume numbers, whatever, it's irrelevant, right? Because at the end of the day, Pierrot is saying, like, this is doing absolutely amazing overseas, it's doing amazing domestically. We can see that through merchandise figures and all that sort of stuff, and especially with streaming platforms such as Disney Plus and whatnot. So there is a more, in comparison to 10 years ago, more of a diversification of where Bleach is and where it's primarily kind of marketed. So you're going to see many different results in terms of figures. But I will say that when you got the licensor for Pierrot basically saying that ever since Bleach kind of deemed the success that it has, it, and I said this, I believe in maybe a video or live streams, that Bleach is going to be that series that really changes Pierrot on how they do things and how they monitor things and how they structure things. And I do believe, you know, it really paved the way for Pierrot to be like, okay, it's time for seasonal anime. We're not going to do the long-running stuff with Black Clover or Boruto anymore. Seasonal is the way forward, and I think Bleach, again, has set that precedent. I think they're kind of prioritizing things a little bit differently, and I think they've restructured things in terms of the labor laws, and again, you'll see on the screen that kind of interview, you'll see that they've taken a little bit of a step back to observe, and now they're going forward with that plan, and I think that is the best way of going into things. We'll see if the results are going to be within Core 3, but I've always believed that Core 4 will be enough time where people have gotten used to the character design sheets, they've gotten used to Bleach, they've kind of got to that point where everything should be solidified in a pre-production level. Even though pre-production should be close to finishing with Core 4, I do believe that Core 4 will be the final kind of quality check of what we can expect Pierrot to kind of do in the future, especially when it comes to Bleach, especially on a broader scale of where we're going to go in the future with Bleach as an IP in general. So that's really cool too. Now, if you guys haven't seen us recently, and this is where we're going to get into my kind of tweet about what I said about Bleach's Core 3 release, is that 32 actors Kubo recently said on his Club Outside, where he also shows a picture with some chocolate. Man loves his chocolate, for sure. I do too. Absolutely goated taste. But we get to see a script on the table, and this is in reference to, well, it says meant in the picture, and you'll see in the image, like, we'll zoom in, and this is a reference to either volume 69 or a chapter in general, where it has the judgment. And if it is 69, and we kind of base things off the trailer as much as we can kind of assume that Core 3 is going to end around about, again, we don't know with the original content and whatnot, but we're looking towards, you know, from what we know, going towards 71 to volume 72, which is going to be an amazing discussion, because then we have two volumes left. And two volumes within Core 4, that's at least 80% of new original content, which people wanted. It's just so bad. We already know we're going to get a lot of original scenes within this core alone, more so than we did in Core 1 and 2 combined. So it's going to be really interesting to see, which we already knew as well. We talked about it ages ago that, you know, the later we get on, the more, you know, because they were doing 6 volumes per season by that logic, going by Core 1. And we wouldn't have even done 6 volumes per core, right? So things would have been stretched out incredibly so. And it seems like that is going to be the case. So, again, Core 4 is for another discussion, but I'm so happy because Ichigo's is Bankai. Hopefully that gets explained. You know, Yuha's final fight, that's going to be really cool too. Aizen, you know, Renji, Rukia, and you know, all that sort of stuff going to get expanded on. Or we're going to get more in terms of other characters. So that's going to be interesting as well. So with all that basically being said and done, is that I tweeted that Bleach Core 3 will be in summer. Now, this was a leak that was given to me by one of my sources in the past. Granted, you know, I'm not as strong as inside information as I used to be. You know, at the end of the day, whether I take the fall, whether I'm wrong, is fine by me, because whether we get it summer, cool, I got it right. If we get it in fall, then cool, even better, right? Because now you have an expectation that it's going to be happening in summer, and you're going to be expecting it in summer, and then when it doesn't hit summer, and you get a better deal by being full, then you're like, okay, cool, we got another 3 months, that's good. So, if anything, I feel like, I was okay to tweet that because it's like, well, here's the standard of, like, summer. And if everyone's happy with that, cool. Everyone's got their expectations. It's still longer than Core 2 and it's still longer than Core 1, just about, in terms of production. So that's good, right? We have the longest production that we've had thus far. So with that being said, if we get an extra another 3 months, even better, right? And Kubo is really working hard on the storyboards as well. We know that for a fact. So when we combine, you know, that leak of summer, which was from, I will say, an animator who kind of leaked it to some degree. And there's some other people too, but again, I'll be very vague, as you know I have to be. I will elaborate by saying, well, when do you start seeing promotion for animes that are going to be happening within 6 to 3 months? Well, you usually see promotion within 6 to 3 months, right? And if Kubo is already working on a poem, which again, something he said on Club Outside, where he said he finds it hard to do a poem for the preview has already been spoke about. I already did a tweet or a video talking about how pre-screenings were going to be, you know, starting relatively soon. So it would make sense, the reservations for pre-screenings, the lotteries that they do. So this all seems to be promotion within the next 3 months is something that is very much in conjunction with how a lot of animes do it. It's usually about 3 to 6 months that promotion usually starts. And if we're already this close to a trailer, given what Kubo is saying and the 32 voice actors, and you know, voice acting is usually the last thing in a production, it really does seem like that once we get that PV, it's going to really be that 3 month mark and summer. So having what I heard, given the marketing practices of what I see is about to be happening, I very do strongly believe that it is going to be summer. Though I will say, even if it is fall, I'll be very happy, regardless of if I get bashed on for that, for being wrong. I think it's a win-win situation either way. It's the longest production, and if we wait a little bit longer and I'm wrong, then it's just a W anyway. So it's like, who cares? It's a win, right? It's an absolute win. So that's my overall thoughts. Bleach 2024 summer. Are you guys happy? Is it good for the summer holidays? Is it good for getting kids to watch it when summer break for Japan and for the US? I think it's perfectly timed. I think it's probably the best time. And yeah, I'm not entirely mad about this. Again, if we've seen what Jujutsu Kaisen could do within 6 months of production for the Shibuya arc, it really doesn't matter primarily on time. Well, of course it matters, but again, I'm really interested in this new staff, right? Because if this new staff is really competent and good, I think that the time that we have is going to be enough. I think enough is fair to say, and I think it's going to be looking promising. So again, we can't really have a deciding factor on whether summer's good or not. So tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think of the summer 2024 leak. Do you think I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? Why do you think so? Let's have a conversation about it. And with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.